was a unique project, and it came along at a time which was, I think, just the right time when we were already in a space where all our different facilities were doing a level of work. And Sincity, being the kind of project it was, highly stylized, it required a certain way of execution which we felt was conducive to being done in India.
Sin City's where you go in with your eyes open, or you don't come out at all.
And simply put, the team sizes that we would require to execute that was not going to be really possible to sort of scale up our international facilities to be able to do something like that. Totally on Sin City, if I catch the conversion and the stereo part and the visual effects put together, maybe close to about 1,500 people touched the project at some point. And with a large part of that being visual effects teams of maybe about 700 to 800 people globally that worked on that. And that required a different approach to execution, running the operation, and that was a unique opportunity for the India teams to start stepping up and actually being able to get in there. The good thing about working with Robert Rodriguez was that, being in located in Austin, Texas, he was always worked with teams all over the world. So it was not a new concept for him. He had delivered his earlier project also working with multiple studios, and he was open to that. The makers, the producers were open to this concept of being able to execute a large part of it in India. And so it was great when we were able to actually put it all down, where we had teams in Vancouver executing a chunk of the work and the Mumbai team supporting it and executing a larger number of shots. So the complete layout for the project happened in India, the complete asset build, all the sets, everything was built in India, and shot execution of more than 1,800 shots were executed out of India. And I'm very proud of the fact that we were able to actually live up to the director's expectations, because Sin City 1 had set a certain mood and a certain tone. A certain expectation was there already from this particular film, and we had to live up to that and we had to surpass that. So part 2 was not just going to be a sequel that just carries on in the same tone. It had to be something different. And that's what our challenge was. So for the first few months, it was actually quite a difficult time for us to be able to actually achieve that and find what is Sin City 2. How is it going to be? What is different from the first part? And that's how we first started making it extremely graphical. Then we started going into a more realistic space, and we had to find that happy medium between the two, where the director actually finally got what he envisioned.
There's only Sin City.
So for all the latest updates on animation, gaming, and visual effects, and Prime Focus, log on to animationexpress.com.